Classic Reginald. His jokes, they always quack me up. Welcome to a new episode of Quack. Today, as usual, we are going to answer three questions about science. No time to lose, let's go! Why is electricity sometimes visible, like lightning or static, but other times invisible, like when an electric eel stuns prey? Electricity is a flow of charged particles. The charges move very slowly, just like a liquid, and this motion is invisible to the eye. When you observe a lightning or a spark, what you're seeing is not electricity, it's plasma, the fourth state of matter. When you apply a voltage across a gap filled with air, the air becomes ionized. It transforms into plasma. It's incredibly hot, it glows, and it's now conductive. So, you don't see electricity. What you see is air transformed into hot conductive plasma.
Well, I don't really have gags for this episode. Maybe I can just like put you here and then I can, I don't know, like sing you a song.
If the surface of water in a glass is allegedly perfectly flat, but we see that the oceans are not, does that mean that the water surface in a glass is not actually flat? There is a constant exchange of molecules between the water in your glass and the air in the room. So the surface is already a very dynamic interface. Also the water molecules, they are not flat. So the concept of flatness at that level of organization doesn't really make sense. Your question is about gravity. The water in our oceans seeks the position that is the closest to the Earth's center. And because of this, it curves and creates a spherical surface. And the same thing is actually happening in your glass. But because the larger the surface, the larger the bulge, the curvature in your glass of water is actually insignificant. In fact, if your glass of water was 10 centimeters in diameter, theoretically, the bulge should be 0.00000002 centimeters. This bulge is very small. It's theoretically smaller than the size of a water molecule. So the water in your glass is subject to the same force as the oceans, but the result is just imperceptible. This doesn't make the water in your glass perfectly flat, though. Because of another property called surface tension, the water tends to curve at the edges of the glass. And this little curve is called meniscus. But we can talk about this in another work.
I am stuck in my home. I'm weaving in some dark. His name is Reginald.
Why does the Earth rotate? Rotation is a behavior we see everywhere in the universe. All planets in our solar system do it. The Sun does it. Stars, black holes, asteroids, all of them, they do it. Even galaxies. But why? In our case, a long time ago, our solar system was a cloud of gas called nebula. As it collapsed due to gravity, it became a spinning disk, rotating faster and faster. Gas and dust ended up forming planets, moons, and asteroids. Today's Earth's rotation is just a vestige of that primordial angular momentum. So since then, Earth keeps rotating. There's not a lot of stuff in outer space to slow things down. But Earth rotation is decelerating, about 1 second every 50,000 years, mainly because of the tidal forces of the moon. In fact, for the dinosaurs, a day was 22 hours long, and not 24 like us.
I love you, Reginald. I'm all alone. I only have a duck as a friend. I love you.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I am right now organizing a couple of art contests on my Discord server, and if you are not part of it, maybe you should join. You can win a t-shirt. Yeah, I know it's not like a lot, it's not like a super big prize, but it's something. Come on. We have nice people, we can hang out together, do live streams and stuff, so come to the Discord server, come. Yeah, so that's it for today. I'll see you next week. Yeah, bye.